If you want Unity 3D, CryEngine, or Unreal Engine tutorials, like, comment, or subscribe for more. Hello everyone, this is Jessica the Rising Phoenix Dev, and today we're going to look at CryEngine. So what we're going to do here is we're going to create a blank C++ project, and let's call it Tutorial Project. And once we have created our project, we should select it so that way it will actually execute the application. Now, I should note that CryEngine does use DirectX 11, so if you don't have that, then CryEngine is not going to work appropriately for you. So now that the project has loaded, we can see our blank editor. You'll notice that the camera is blank, everything is blank. So what we want to do is click on File, New, create a new level, and we're just going to call this Toot Level. Now I'm going to change the texture dimensions, height map resolution, meters per unit, all the way down to their lowest form, and terrain color multiplier up to the maximum. And this will load up our level, which has a basic square terrain. Now let's go ahead and zoom out and just take a look at how big it is. Now you should also notice that there is water, and look at how beautiful that water looks. That's already built into the scene, and we already have a beautiful sun as well, with fog as in the scene. So let's zoom in here a little bit. And what we're going to do here is look at the objects that we can create. So the first one is our AI. And it has very basic things that all AIs require. Next up is audio, ambience, random area entity, trigger spot. We also have components. Now there's a lot of these. Physics constraints, physics themselves with colliders, lights, we have geometry, we have general, we have effects, we have debug, we have cameras, regular audio, and AI. After that, we have an empty entity along with area, which gives us a few other selections here. We have a brush, which works with our objects that we have in the scene. We have designer, which allows us to create things based off these components. We have miscellaneous, which has cameras, environmental probes, rivers, ropes, spline, distributors, road. And the final one that we have is static mesh entity. Now, we only have sphere here. In a blank project, it doesn't give us any other ones that are built inside. So what we're going to do here is we are going to create some objects to be able to add to our scene to manipulate. So let's start off with the cube. We're just going to go with the regular cube. And this is important. It needs to be an FBX format. So let's go ahead and just create a simple folder in our desktop with the name CryEngine, just to simplify everything. Alright, and let's rename it to be, instead of Untitled, let's call this Cube. And then we'll export the file. Now let's go ahead and delete the cube from Blender. And let's add another mesh. Oops, wrong button. There we go, mesh. Let's go with the... let's go with the cylinder. And we'll export this as well as FBX. And we'll call this one Cylinder. We'll go ahead and delete the cylinder now. And you know what? We're just going to do all of these. So we'll have our cone. We'll name it cone and then export the file. Delete the cone. So on and so forth. Next up, we'll do the Taurus. Export. Let's see, how is Taurus spelled again? T-O-R-U-S? No. T-O-R-O-U-S? That doesn't look right. You know what? I'll just keep it. All right, let's delete the Taurus now. Let's also create an icosphere. Or, no, let's go with the monkey head. And we'll call it monkey. Delete it. And, whoops. Let's see. No, put that back in. And we're going to create our UV sphere. Yeah, that looks good. Export. UV sphere. Delete the UV sphere. Now, icosphere. Export. FBX. Icosphere. And we're going to close out Blender now. So now we're going to create a new folder by right-clicking. Click on New Folder. And I'm going to call this one Basic Shapes. So we'll click on that folder. And now we're going to click on Import. And we have to locate the folder in which we saved everything. In this case, it would be Desktop and CryEngine. So we see all of them there. So let's select all of them and import. And we'll just select import instead of import all because I'm an idiot. And we'll continue to do this. Again. And again. And again. And again. And then finally, import. So there we go. So now, we'll just click on the prefabs and drag them into the scene. They're going through the floor. So let's click on this move tool, which will allow us to put it above. There we go. That looks good. We'll do the same thing. Wrong cylinder. There we go. We want the model, not the MTL. The monkey head. Taurus. And the UV sphere. And we can control the... we'll also do the regular sphere that they have. We can also control the camera by pressing the WASD keys and the mouse. So there we go. And we can see that there's no textures on these. And that is because that will be part of another lesson.